to understand where we are with COVID-19, we want to be speaking to those who have the information. And this evening, we are very lucky, or you could say, we are chanced to have the chair of the Science Advisory Committee on COVID-19, Dr. Misaki Wayengera, who is with us this evening. Doc, a very good evening.
Thank you.
As far as COVID-19 is concerned, where are we at as a nation?
So we are at a very worrying situation. We have a situation that is very rapidly evolving and could potentially turn chaotic. Just to tell you a little bit, it took us about a month to have numbers raised from 20 to 50. And it's taken us about 2 weeks to have these numbers turn from 50 to 100. And within a few days, we've already hit 200. And that's what explains that in the last 7 days, we've accumulated over close to 1,350 cases just in a week.
It is a worrying situation, but if you're going to deal with it, then you have to need resources.
Yes.
What kind of resources are available for us as a country to do what you could call push back against a pandemic?
So number one thing is our history in terms of dealing with pandemics. We rapidly set in place a structure for response to the COVID-19. Which structure is, of course, commanded by the president himself. We have the Prime Minister's task force, under whom we have several things, but that's more operational. We've built capacities for surveillance. We've built capacities for contact tracing. We've built capacities for care. We've built capacity for laboratory testing. Trust me, Uganda is doing so well as far as testing is concerned. But at the same time, of course, we've built capacity for community engagement and communication. And unfortunately, of course, no country can ever have enough resources for the response.
Well, no country can have enough resources, but are we in a place where we could say that not too bad resource-wise shortly?
It is a balance. We're looking at a situation which could easily go out of, more or less, we're looking at an equilibrium situation. It could go either way.
Okay.
If the numbers continue rising uncontrolled, we could easily run out of the capacity that we've built.
Okay. Very briefly, many are concerned over the idea of lockdown. Lockdown or no lockdown? Is a lockdown something the ministry is seriously considering, looking at what some have even called belligerence from the public?
Well, at the end of the day, one of the disturbing things is that we have a disconnect between what people are doing in public in terms of their risk perception and the messages that we're sending out. And that becomes unfortunate because at the response in terms of public health control of the pandemic needs to be a relationship between us, the technical people, and then the public. But unfortunately, we're not seeing the compliance coming from the public. And in such times, if we are threatened by a situation where our capacities will be overrun, we have no option but to close down. These are decisions that we've seen the UK take. We've seen Kenya take these decisions. We've seen India fail to take these decisions, and you can see the situation where they are. We don't want to get there.
Thank you very much, Dr. Misaki Wayengera.